thank you. Hello. And I was working last Thursday, and I finished about 8:30 in the evening. And I was tired, hungry, so I said, let me stop off at Musso and Frank's in downtown Hollywood, get something to eat. So I stopped there. I hadn't been there for about 9 months. And after I finish eating, I go out into the parking lot, and standing in the parking lot is Tyne Daly. It's the strangest thing. She had been doing a talk show about three blocks away, and she says, I know John goes over to Musso's every once in a while. Let me just stop over and see if he's there. Hadn't been there in 9 months, so just think of that as a coincidence. And then we went back and had about four or five drinks and had a nice time, you know.
We had some clips of Mr. Carlin on Dark Shadows and other things. And
Willie.
You can have your feet.
Willie. You know what you have to do, Willie.
You gotta remember that's one tape. You only got one chance on tape.
Did you have any idea what you were getting into with letting Barnabas out of the coffin?
No, none of us did at that time, actually, you know, that it was gonna, you know, be such a phenomena. None of us. We just, you know, that was. I think they expected, you know, just to go from, you know, one thing to another, to another, to another. But Jonathan, being as great as he was, it just, you know, that was it.
Yeah, you. I got a right to be mad at you. You ain't no friend of mine.
No, sir.
Why don't you growl at me? I brought you a snack. 10 o'clock feeding for the baby.
Strangest part, slight recollections of that scene. I like it better now when I see it. It's all done so quick. We all do it in one, you know, once, and that's it. So it's, you know, whatever lines, I don't know.
It was good.
Fun show to do. Got a chance to act, which is wonderful.
Did you like Robert Rodin working with him?
Yeah. Well, I love it. Sure, Bob was great there, right there. I thought that was a fun scene right there.
Open the door.
Then you have to stay here.
Until dusk, at least.
Oh, no, Quentin, please don't!
Thanks for closing the door.
Oh, no.
Yes, no. No. And close it. And remember, and do it with one hand, while the gun is in the other.
Oh, no, no, Quentin. Oh, no, no, Quentin! For God's sake, I am dead! I'm dead!
I can't say I didn't try.
They ran that again the next day. That was the opening. Right. And then they had fixed it so it was...
Right. Right.
Oh, did they? And I did it. I see.
Redid it. It kind of didn't move.
All right. I like it better this way.
Do you recall any description the producers gave you in terms of the Carl Collins or did they like...
You mean to tell me how to do it? Nothing. No. I just, they let me alone.
They let you
alone. Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. They told me it was crazy and I went from there. Or whatever. I professional suicide on this show quite often, you know. I mean, the demands made on you were tremendous.
Get this to Collins. Books and light. They tell you what to do, even the vampires are legendary. Only Carolyn and I know they're not, don't we, Mr. Collins? Only she can't help you. Oh, I should. I used to be a reporter. Now, where did you come from? Tell me.
Another band of time.
What?
Yes, another time exists. With another Will Loomis, another Calvin, all living in this estate.
You? You exist in this other time?
As I am, yes. You see, I am the first bond of his college. The man you've written about, the son of Joshua. I discovered a room in Collinwood, Angelique's room. I could see you there. I watched you the day that Julia threw the book into the hall. The book came from your time to mine. I picked it up.
Look. Oh, look at last.
What are you going to do with him?
Oh, I need you, Mr. Collins. Oh, how I need you. You're going to make me my fortune. What a book! A crime! I'm taking no chances, Mr. Collins. Get in. You're going to be my prisoner. My hope. My salvation. Yes. My salvation.
I'd sure like to see her.
Is she still back here?
I think so. Somebody said you keep hearing different reports on these people.
She lives near Lewis Edmonds, actually.
Really? Does she? Yeah.
Is she on Long Island?
I think Manhattan. I'm not sure.
What
was she like back then?
Sweet lady. Very, very sweet lady. Good lady. Good person. Good lady. Most of the people were. I don't remember, just a good show, good people.
She got married to David Ford.
Oh, yeah, and that was awful. Now, David has passed away, but they were already split on the show, I think. And so that was over a long time already. But David is our gone, right?
David Ford. Oh, David Ford is
gone. Gone where? Now, could you just keep talking? Tell me, finish it, boy. Where? So David, oh my God, what a list.
Joe Brothers.
I know Joe, Hall. Of course, Thayer David.
Virginia Bethstock.
Oh, Jesus.
We've heard about Jonathan's stories on various Cologne lines, or he's thinking about what he's going to say.
Yeah.
From my knowledge, you didn't have that much of a problem where you were just going through a lot of acting stages, or did you indeed have some problems with some clients that you didn't know about?
Very seldom. Very, very seldom. Very seldom.
Jonathan was a classic.
But Jonathan had so much to do.
What are the chances of a lot of the cast getting together and doing anything that is dark shows related?
Absolutely, one of stuntmen zipped in there and did his number.
Alex Stevens, right, who often played the werewolf.
Alex is great. I just ran into Alex in New York in July, back there a while. He was staggering along 8th Avenue. But in good shape. Just been out the night before. Great out. Oh, no, I don't. Jesus, darn. I don't know.
He's in Memphis, Tennessee.
Is he really? What's he doing?
Sure, he lives with his father.
Is that right, huh? Yeah.
He doesn't seem interested in coming to a convention.
Right, right.
He can change his mind.
On Briscoe. That was good actor, too bad he,
And next is a scene from Daughters of Darkness.
Daughters of Darkness? My God.
Well, you haven't been embarrassed yet.
Is this embarrassing? Why?
Yeah, no, okay.
By the way, they're running that uncut on Z Channel.
No, tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night on Z Channel?
Yeah.
You're kidding.
Why?
Isn't that on Halloween night they're doing it? Thank you for that. Thank you, dear.
morning, I called my mother.
Mother, and tell her we are arriving.
I'm still trying to figure out what kind of an actor I am.
Oh, dear.
An actor who has to lose some weight for... What happened? What happened to my nice, slender body? What the hell happened? Thank you. I was even out of shape in this damn movie. I had lost my... God almighty. It's tough business, this acting. Emotionally disturbs you. What is this? Hey! Here. Look at this. The things you gotta do to make a living in this business. Look at this. Look at how wonderful she looked in this lady. I'm being serious.
Where was that movie made again?
Belgium, Ostend and Brussels. A great time making that movie. Fun.
Well, who was the director?
Yes, I remember his name. His name was, as Harry Kummel. I think Harry Kummel. He was a Belgian, and I don't think he ever made another movie, although he was incredibly talented. I thought that was a well-done movie for the short time that it, you know, I mean, for
it
the,
was.
For the you know, I mean, the fact that it's playing tomorrow night on Z, and it's, you know, it has, I wish we had a few more weeks to shoot it so we could take some of it, you know, to brighten it up, you know.
The character who played that was really an odious heel.
Really? Yeah. Well, there you go. You know, it's one of the few things, believe it or not, that my son likes that I've done.
Yeah.
It's weird. He really, you know, and some people, that's a cult movie to some people. I think the fact that it's playing tomorrow night twice says something after 20 years, you know, almost.
Wasn't your son in an episode of Freddy Tonight?
Yes, he was. He's starting to act now. Yeah. Did you see it?
I didn't see it, but yeah. I'm getting a copy of it.
Yeah, he's a very good-looking kid. He's a good-looking man. Tomorrow and Thursday.
Yeah, Wednesday. I think tomorrow.
Great. Thanks.
A-N-G-E-L-I-Q-U-E.
Thank you, dear. Thank you so much.
You were terrific.
Hi, sweetheart.
My name's Shirley.
Hi, Shirley. Any place in particular?
Oh, just anywhere. This was the let me
put
it.
Okay.
They were all such a good group under our tent, but I think Willie was the best. Okay.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Hi there. How are you?
No.
Evelyn.
Hi, Evelyn.
It's Christopher Pennell. No.
E-V-E-L-Y-N, right? There you go. Who we got here? We got everybody in there.
Everyone except the author, so far.
Yeah, except the author. Thank you, sweetheart.
Dark Shadows, the show that never dies.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Hi, darling. How are you?
Fine. I'll just tell my name because I'll get another one.
What is it?
Suzanne.
S-U-Z-A-N-N-E.
I saw this house, too, and it was important.
Thank you, Tom. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much. How are you? Good.
This is amazing. Press release. I recall seeing that in so many tables. This is a major press release.
Thank you very much, dear. Thanks a lot.